Okay, today I will teach you about the next important data structure that you can use this data structure step in many applications in computer science and computer engineering application. Okay, so today the outlines will be like start from the what does it mean by stack, and then we are going to present two representations of stack. The first one is array that is very simple and easy to implement. And the second one will be the linked list that you have already tried to develop the C program, right? This one is a bit more difficult, but it is very flexible. So you can use either array or linked list to represent the stack. And then I will talk about the operations on the stack as well. And then I will end up today's class with the application of stack. Okay, this will be the topics that I would like to tell you today. First of all, I would like to begin with the definition of stack. Maybe some of you understand or know about stack before, but some maybe you don't understand about it. So first of all, I would like to introduce you stack. Stack is an important data structure that stores it in elements in an ordered manner. What does it mean? Let's look at the picture on the right-hand side. You can see what we call the plate, right? Just the stack of plates, right? We say it is a stack because we will think about it as a kind of the stack of plates or a stack of things that we can, okay, can be like this, the stack of plate or stack of bricks, right? So okay, we can call it this kind of the data structure as a stack, but why do we have to use this? But you can think about the stack, right? The pile of plate, where one plate is placed on top of another, right? Placed on top of another, okay? This one we call stack. So now when you want to remove a plate, which one will be moved, will be removed first? Suppose you have a stack like this, which one will be removed first? The first one, right, the top one, right, the topmost one will be removed first, because if it was placed in the order manner like this, ordered manner like this, so the top one or the topmost will be removed first. This is the operation, or this is the nature of the stack. Okay. Okay, let's have a look. Right. Now the question is, where do we need stacks in computer science or engineering, right? Okay, the answer is we use stack in function call. We have already studied about function call, and some may implement them frequently, but you don't know the engine or the organization inside of the operating system, right? How they can implement the stack. This is the answer, right? In computer, if you want to implement the function call, and then when you execute it, right, it will work like a stack manner. Okay, so first of all, when A calls B, function A calls function B, right, A will be pushed. This is an operation, push. What does it mean by push? Push means, suppose we define this as a stack, right? The push one, the push operation means we push function A into the stack. This is the, we call push operator. A is put on top of the stack. When execution of B complete, the system control will remove A from the stack and continue with its execution. Okay, so when we have function A, right, A will be pushed into the stack, and then A calls B. When A is called B, function B will be pushed into the stack. Okay, function B will be pushed into the stack. But when B calls C again, C will be pushed into the stack as well. And then when C calls D, right, function D will be pushed on the top of the stack. This is the way that the operating system will do, right, when the function calls are executed. Okay, this is what we call the stack. Once function D completed, once D completed, okay. D completed, then D will be pop off the stack, and then the stack will be like this, right? Once function C is completed, right, C will be pop off the stack. So the function in the stack will be like this, function A and function B. Once B finish, B will be pop. And the last one, when we complete function A will be pop off the stack, and then the program will be terminated. This is the way that the function call does, right? There are many function call, right? Okay, this is the things that I have just talked to you, right? This side is show the push operations, right? Once A has been called, main calls A, right? So A will be pushed into this stack. And then inside A calls B. So B will be pushed into the stack. And then B calls C and C calls D, right? And D calls E. When E has executed, and D will be removed by function pop. And then this is the stack. And then pop C, so you can get B and A. And pop B, then we have the function A. When B has executed, A will be removed for the execution. Okay, so this is the way that stack performs. So here we come to the next slide, which is how can we represent the stack. The first data structure that we can use for implementing stack is array, right? Array is the simplest one, right? In computer memory, stack can be represented as a linear array. Array is always linear. Every stack has a variable called the top associated with it. Okay, what does it mean by top, right? Top is a special variable, right, for a stack, right? If you declare a stack, right, top will be referenced to the topmost of the stack, okay? Which is used to store the address of the topmost element of the stack. Okay, in this way, maybe this one will be maybe a bit not clear about the stack, right? I write this one? When I push A, right, and then I push B and push C, put D and push E, right? So now this one is top of stack. Top of stack will point to the array 4, right? If you think about the stack, if you think about the array in C programming, the first index will be 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So the value that is kept in the variable top will be 4. Top is equal to 4. Okay. So this is the way that we represent the stack using array. Okay, A, B, C, D, E, F will be pushed into the stack, and top of the stack will reference to the topmost of the stack. And if we want to remove or if we want to get a value from the stack, we can use pop value or pop function. Pop function will go to the what we call the index 4 or the index top, right? So for example, this is stack, right? So if you want, if you pop it, you have to go to the place that index top, right? This will pop the stack, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, I have mentioned many times about the operations on stack, right? Normally we have two main operations on the stack, right? Push and pop. But I don't know, nowadays you also have a peak. Peak is a kind of pop, but pop means when you pop and you get the value of the topmost value of the stack, right? But peak, you will get the value of the topmost of the stack, but you will not remove the top. Okay, once again, push operation means to add an element to the top of stack. And then top will be increment top plus plus, right? When you push something on the stack, it means that we want to add an element to the top of the stack. And the second operation is the pop operation. Pop operation will remove the element from the top of the stack. I'm going to show you about this in detail. And the last one, the peak operation, will return the value of the topmost element of the stack, okay, without delete or remove the element of the top of the stack. Okay, we will start from the first one, that is a push operation. What does it mean by push operation? As it name, right? The push operation is used to insert an element into the stack. Insert an element into the stack. The new element is inserted in the topmost position of the stack. Where is the topmost position? Topmost position is where the top variable points to. Right? Before inserting the value, you must first check if top, okay, we also have the variable or the constant max. Max means the maximum number of the element in the stack. Max is the maximum number of the elements in the stack. Okay, max is the maximum number of the elements in the stack. And top will be not more than max because it is implemented using array, right? So the maximum value will be the index of the maximum value will be max minus one. Okay, max minus one will be the top. So if top is equal to max minus one, so it means that you cannot push anything onto the stack, okay? If top is equal to max minus one, it means that you cannot insert any value in the stack, right? But, okay, if an attempt to insert a value in the stack, an overflow message will be printed. Overflow is another flag of stack, right? Overflow means you cannot push any value into the stack. So in the push function, you may have to check for the top, right? If top is less than max minus one, so you can use or you can perform push operation, okay? Okay, this is an example of the push operation. For example, if you have the top of the stack points to the index 4, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the fifth element index 4, right? Because it is an array, right? In C programming, with the index will start from 0 to 4. So if we want to insert an element with the value 6, so first of all, we have to check for the top, right? So I have a question. In this example, what is stored in max variable? Max is equal to what? Nine or 10. Right? Because we have 10 elements for this step, right? Starting with the index from 0 to 9. So the max value, max, you saw 10, right? So in this case, right, max, okay, top is 4, is not equal to 10 minus 1, that is 9. So you can push the step. So in this case, we push the stack to the value top plus one, right? So that top plus one will be assigned with 6, right? 6 is a element that we are going to insert in this stack, right? Stack top plus one is equal to 6, right? It means that 6 will be assigned to this, right? And then top plus plus, right? We will increment the top indicator. Okay, this is the way that push operation will do. Are you still happy? So easy, right? Do you have any question up to now? If you have any question, you can press 1. So I will know that you don't understand, and I will explain it again. Okay, I think it's still okay, right? It's still not difficult. So I will move to the next operation, which is pop. Before we go to the push operation, so I will tell you and show you about the algorithm to insert an element in a stack. Okay, step one. First of all, you have to check for the top, right? The top value. If top is equal to max minus one, then print overflow. It means that top is here. For example, top is here, and a value here, right, is 9, right? If top is equal to 9, and it means that there is something, some value inside here, so you cannot push into another slot. So it's not possible. So you have to show print overflow and then go to step 4. It means end. But if not, right, you have to set top is equal to top plus one, right? And then stack top, stack index top will be assigned to a value, right? A given value. So this is all of this push function or push operation. So if you want to implement using C and array, right? So you have, first of all, you have to, okay, this one is the first argument, right? First argument is stack, right? Stack of integer. And then integer value means the value that we are going to put into the stack. So first of all, you have to check for this condition top is equal to max minus one or not. If that's true, so the stack overflow will be printed. But if not, we go to else and then top plus and then stack index top will be assigned with the value wow, val. Okay, and that's all. This is what we call push function. Okay, it's easy. So I will move to pop operation. the pop operation is in opposite, right? It used to delete the topmost element from the stack and then return the value of the topmost of the stack too. However, before deleting the value, you must first check if the top is equal to now or not, right? If it is now or nothing in this stack and you are trying to pop something or pop a value from the stack. So the message under flow, message will be printed, okay? Under flow, right? Will be printed, right? So first of all, for the pop operation, you have to say, to check for the emptiness of the stack, right? If it's okay, there is a variable or a value in inside the stack, so you can pop something out of the stack. But if not, the under flow message will be printed. So this one is the example of how we can perform the pop operation. For example, if you have the value inside the stack like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the top of stack will be 4. And then once you want to pop this stack, right, to delete the topmost element, first of all, you have to check for the top. Top is now or not now, top is not now, top is 4. So if the condition is false, then we will decrement the value, right, printed by top, and then get the value of, return this value, right? Okay, and then reduce or decrease the value pointed by top. Okay, so what will we do, right? The algorithm for pop operation will be, first of all, you have to check whether top is now or not. If it is now, so you can just simply print under flow and then go to the step 4 and then end of this function. But if not, right, you have to set the value, right, wow, right, is equal to such that top, the current value of the stack, right, where top index is pointed to. Okay, so the value of the stack, right, where the top is pointed to is 5. So value is equal to 5 in this case. Okay, but value is equal to 5, and then you decrease the top by 1, right? So you can get the result. And if you want to convert from an algorithm to the C function, right, you can use, okay, this one is the return data type, which is the integer. Integer means we return the value, right? Return the value that we pop of the stack. After popping the value, do we need to assign the pop value to now? No, we don't need to. What does it mean by now? Now will be used when you or the top of stack is not an integer. Now top of stack. If top of stack is the top is 0, so there is one element but once we pop this one out, then we cannot assign -1. Oh, maybe in this case now is 1. Now is -1. Okay, that's right. You can see that after suppose we have only one element left, when you pop, right, top will be 0, -1. So top now will be -1, right? So if you want to check for the stack underflow, right, you have to check the value top is equal to -1. Okay, instead of using now, actually you have to check if top is equal to -1. So maybe in this case, right, in the case of the algorithm, right, so instead of using minus one, that is quite legit, right? So you can use now or you can use minus one, right? Just in case that if the array of like Pascal or Fortran, right, index will start from one. So in this case, you can use to check the top offset to be zero, or zero is equal to now, right? Actually, now is equal to zero L like this. But in this case, for the case of the C programming, if you use top minus one, so the top, when the top is equal to minus one, so you cannot pop anything from the stack and then return minus one. Return minus one means the value is dummy, that is minus one. But else, value is equal to the top of the stack and then top minus minus and then return the value to this function pop. Okay, function pop will return the value of the current position of the stack. The current position of the stack is when is stack top. Current position is stack top. Okay. I hope that I answer the question, Cop. Mm-hmm. Okay, and the last operation that is a peak. This is a special operation. I have never heard this before as well, right? But this may be the new name, or sometimes we not use peak operation much, right? Actually, peak is an operation that will return the value of the topmost of the stack. We just want to check for the, maybe sometimes we want to check the value of the topmost of the stack, right? Without deleting it from the stack. So we can use the peak operation. However, you have to check for the status of the stack as well. If the stack is empty, right? So the top is equal to now, right? If the top is equal to now, then you cannot pop anything or we cannot get any value from the peak operation. So from this one, this example, if you use peak operation, the value five will be returned. Right? Value five will be returned to the function call. Okay? Because for peak operation, the value will be the value of the top element of the stack. So if you want to implement peak, it's very similar to pop, right? Except you don't have to change the value of the top, right? So you can just simply check for emptiness of the stack, right? If top is equal to minus one, then there's nothing in this stack. So you can print stack is empty. And then else, you can just simply return stack top the value of the stack, right? At the topmost position. And then this one will be integer, it will return to this. Okay, and that's all. So I try to compare these two operations, right? For pop and peak, right? For they are very similar, except that you don't have to put top minus minus to decrease the index for top, right? For the peak. For peak, we can just simply return stack top. Okay, that's all. Okay, if you don't have any question, I will continue with the next slide. That is how can we implement a stack using linked list this technique is to create the step, but sometimes but for the array class, right? The array, you have to declare the size of the step first, so it's not flexible, right? This is a drawback of using array for the step. That is, you have to declare the maximum, the possible maximum number of the stack, right? Just in case of the stack is very small, or you have known the number of the maximum size in that one, so the stack implementation by array is okay, reasonable, right? You can use array implementation for the stack, right? Because of its efficiency. Okay, but sometimes you don't know about the size of the stack in advance, or sometimes the stack might be flexible, right? So in order to do that, or in order to represent that, you may have to use the other kinds of data structure, that is the linked list. For the stack, linked list can be used, right? So in this case, right, if you start from the value 5, right, you put into the stack, and then we put 6 into the stack, and then push 2 into the stack, right, and push 4 into the stack. What does it mean by this linked list? This linked list means you are going to insert the new element to the head. You can see that? This one, you can insert the element into the head. This one is head of the linked list, right? You will insert the new value to the head, and the head will be the top of the stack as well. So in this case, right, once you want to insert, you can insert, you can use insert first. Are you familiar with this function? I have already given you yesterday, right, in my program. Right, insert first, right? So the program that I gave you yesterday for the linked list, and I use the insert first, this is a kind of the linked list implementation of the stack. You can also use that program in order to write a program to represent the stack, okay? The solid requirements of linked representation of stack with n element is big O n, okay? Big O n, because it is a linear operation. The typical time requirements for the operation is big O one, okay? It's a constant time. In a linked stack, we can call this that every node has two parts. The first part will store the data, and the second part will store the address of the next node. If you could remember for the linked list, right? When you implement linked list, one thing that you have to keep in mind is that you have more or extra storage, right? Extra storage will store the address of the next node, right? So in order to implement a stack using the linked list representation, the start pointer of the linked list is used as top. Start pointer or head will point to the top of the stack. Am I right? The head or the starter or the start will point to the top of the stack, right? All insertion and deletion are done at the node pointed by top, okay? Or insertion, if you want to insert or if you want to delete the element of the stack, it has to be done at the node that pointed by top or the first node. The first node will, if top is equal to null, then it indicates that the stack is empty. If head or if start or top, if top is equal to null, right? So nothing inside the stack. Okay, I forget to tell you one thing about stack. Stack We have first in, first out. First in, first out of FIFO. FIFO means first in, first out. First in, first out is for queue. You may have to know about this terminology. First in, first out. Who come first? You can get first. But for stack, it is LIFO. Last in, first out. You can see this example. 9 is last in, right? But it will be first out to be removed. The first element to be removed. When you use pop, 9 will be removed first. So we call these kinds of representation, or we can call the manner as a LIFO, last in, first out manner. Okay, that's that. It's LIFO. Okay, so here we go to the operation. Yeah, okay. Similar to the case of the peak, right? Operate, there are two basic operations for the stack, push, pop, and peak. We can start from push operation. For example, if you have the top point to the first, the last in, right? The last in node, right? So if you want to push 9 into this stack, you can just simply, okay, top point to here, then first you have to allocate this one and top point to this, and this will pop top, this will point to the address that top points to, and then top will change to point to this node, and that's all. Okay, so here we can have top here, and then this one will point to here. So this is the way that we are going to implement the link stack. Okay, so we can see this algorithm. Okay, this algorithm is maybe a bit complicated than the stack, but we will go step by step. Okay, first of all, you have to allocate memory for the new node, right? The new node, right? And then set new node data. New node data will be equal to variable or value. Value will be assigned to new node data. And then for the next step, if top is equal to now, so we want to insert we use the program like insert first, right? Insert first, you have to check if top is equal to now. So nothing has been initialized or nothing is in the stack, right? So you will have to set new node dot next to be now. Okay, you have allocated this one that is as a new node, right? New node dot next is equal to now. And then, okay, we have already set the value, right? For in the step two, and then set this to now, the next to now, and then top is equal to new node. Top is equal to new node. So this is the result of the first if clause. So the result will be top will point to the only one element that we have just allocate the memory. But if we have like this, right, we already have a one value here. And then if it is top is not now, then we may have to allocate this one. Okay, new node dot next, this is here, will point to the place that top is pointed to now. This one will point to this one. And then you have to redirect top to new node, so top here is disappear. So top will be pointed to here, and this will be pointed to the place that top is pointed to. And then end of if, and then end. So this is the way that we are going to push. This is a push operation for the linked list. Right? We can use insert first. Okay. if you cannot catch my words, please press one, right? So I can know that I will have to explain about this algorithm again. If you don't have any question, I will go to the part of C program, okay? So in the part of C program, right, we use the word, we use the function push, right? Push to represent the insert first. Okay, this function will return the address of the structure stack. Why you can call this? Because this star, right? So this is address. Okay, address of what? Address of structure stack. And then the first parameter will be the address of the stack. And integer value means the value that we are going to push into the stack. So we have to start from the first one, that is a link pointer, right? Pointer is a address of the stack. And then pointer will point to the, we are going to allocate memory for the size of stack, right? Allocate for the size of stack. And then return the value or the address of this value. So this statement will allocate new pointer or new structure of the stack, and then pointer will point to this. And that's all. Pointer will keep the address of this node, right? And that's all. Then if top is equal to now, it means that stack is empty. So this is the initialization part. If the stack is empty, so it's very easy because we have already have the pointer ptr to this node, right? So pointer next equal to now, I use this as a now. And then top is equal to pointer. Top is equal to pointer. And actually you have to set the value to the data first value here. So for the first case, you can get top will point to only one node, right? This is one. Okay, this is the first case. But suppose the top is not now. Okay, now top is not now, right? Top is not now here. So you have to start from the allocation, memory allocation like this, memory allocation, and then set data to value. For example, this value may be 9. Okay, and then pointer. Now pointer to here. Pointer.next is top. Pointer.next is here. We'll point to the address that top points to. So it's here, okay? And then top is equal to the pointer. So top will be here, okay? Okay, so this is the implementation of the push function in C programming using linked list. Okay, maybe you can try to read this program first. I will be back for a while. I will be back in 2 minutes. Okay, do you have any question about push operation? Maybe if you want to make it more understandable, you may have to try to write a program and implement this. Okay, that will make you more understandable. You will understand more about this function. Okay, this is a push operation. I think it's more or less like an insert first that I gave you yesterday. Okay. And the next one is pop operation, right? Okay, pop operation is to pop the first, delete first. Pop operation will be equal to delete first. Okay, delete first is very simple, right? You can just change. Okay, if you have, okay, I will go back to this. If you have the first, the top like this, right? Top is to the first element here. If you want to pop, right? So you have to get the value, like this one. The value 9 will be placed. Value is equal 9, and then top will move to here, to the second element, and that's all of the pop operation. So top will move to top next. Okay, top will move to top next, and then you have to free the pointer, right? Where pointer? The pointer that the top points to previously. Okay, this is very, very easy. And then return top. Okay, return top means return the value. Return the header value of the stack. Okay, this is a pop operation. And then this is the implementation of the pop operation by using C programming. Okay. I think I will stop. I will have a break for 10 minutes and then you can go to the restroom or you can drink the water. And then I will be back at 2:35. Okay. And then we will talk about the application of stack.